Hey guys, this is David Kwan. So in this video is like a response to one of the articles I read. And I think I read it on Forbes.com. I can't really remember the source. But the article was kind of a study and a survey. And it asked a question like, hey, are wealthy people less generous than poor people? And if so, why? And they, you know, the statistics that is interesting here is that the average amount of charitable giving, average percentage of charitable giving from a person like living in poverty or near poverty, it turned out to be like 3% of their average income or annual income or whatever. With the wealthy, it was like 1%. So it's dramatically less. So they wanted to like kind of just explore this whole thing, like, well, why are why do the wealthy give less of their percentage of their income to charities and donations? Which is interesting. Although, you know, I guess if you put it in the percentage-wise, the wealthy are less generous, but I bet if you put it in the actual money amount, because of the wealth of wealthy people, I feel like 1% of their wealth is actually a lot more than the 3% that they do make. But it is an interesting point that people who are not wealthy or not in a wealthy situation tend to give more of their wealth. So it's asking like why would people in working associations be more generous in that regards? And the article also kind of went over like the types of charities. So the wealthy tend to, on average, they tend to donate to charities that are kind of like not social programs, like not like nonprofit organizations that, for example, would work on poverty or homelessness or unemployment, for example, but more on arts and artistic institutions and universities, like their alma mater, and things of that nature. So that was interesting, you know, that the, you know, for example, they would give their money to, you know, Princeton or Metropolitan Museum of Art and History. So a lot of their charitable giving goes to those kind of institutions more so than a social service organization. Something like where I'm volunteering right now, which is Housing Works, which is provides housing assistance services to people living with HIV and AIDS. They say that people in poverty tend to donate more to those types of organizations, and the wealthy people tend to donate more to organizations that are, more about education, arts, history, and public broadcast, and things of that nature. All of those nonprofits are great. I feel like, you know, it's arts and history and university institutions are really great, as well as social service organizations. But there is a really interesting distinction here, which I find interesting. And I think that the main reason that the article argues, or article thinks, or a lot of the people in the article think, and I kind of agree, is that people, the wealthy people tend to be in this environment where most of their neighbors are also wealthy. So they're kind of isolated from a lot of the environments where people are in poverty, people need social help, and so they are kind of removed from that world. So that's one of the surveys that mentioned in the article was they had a survey where people, the wealthy people, were shown footages of people in need, and then asked to, asked about their opinions on which organizations they would like to donate. In that case, you know, they were more generous in their responses, and they actually tend to prefer to donate to like social service organizations. Whereas if they weren't shown that video before, they would pretty much donate less, and also donate to organizations that are more arts and history and education focused. So that was interesting, and it's just an interesting thing to think about. I don't really have a strong opinion on this topic at all. I just thought to kind of just talk about it. What was interesting to me was when I was a canvasser, as a door canvasser, I really went to, so I did street canvassing and I did door canvassing. and two, it turns out, are pretty different way, two completely different. Because door canvassers, I really went to like super rich neighborhoods. I went to like what felt like mansions and knocked on their doors or rang the bell or pushed the button on this video webcam intercom system on their door. Amazing stuff. And you know, it was so hard to fundraise in the wealthy neighborhoods. Not many people give, and when they give not that much, which was interesting. I met a person in Brooklyn who was just like, yeah, I go to your organization's annual fundraiser, I give $50,000 every year. And I was like, that's amazing. And then so I asked, you know, just fundraise if she can give a little bit today. And you know, all she gave like $20, I think, which was interesting. That's like chump change for her if she's able to just give $50,000 a year, just like that, you know. So that was an interesting thing I noticed. And then on the street canvassing, I noticed that a lot of people, majority of people who were receptive into giving money to the organization I was fundraising for, were people who were like unemployed or people who were like not making that much money, but they were so willing to like become monthly donors, you know, giving money every month. They were signed up for that. So that was really interesting to see that people who are not wealthy tend to be the most generous in my personal experience as well. And you know, that's why the numbers don't tell the whole story in canvassing, I think. Sometimes I get a really big amount, but it feels like that person just gave that amount, like, it's just like, this is chump change for me, here's a check for $250, here you go. And it's just like, okay, well, thank you so much, but to that person, it's just like, $250 is my equivalent of 25 cents, you know? There was that kind of wealthy people. And then, there are those people who gave, like, $20, but to them, it meant so much of their percentage of, you know, what they can give. And I was, like, so moved by that people can be that generous even when they're having such hard, difficult times. And that's probably because people in need situations, people in poverty, because they're in that situation, they understand other people in need. I guess this is the logic behind why they are more generous. You know, that because they understand what it's like to go through it, because they're going through it themselves, they're willing to be more generous and stuff. I'll end this video with one story I'll share. When I was door canvassing, I met this person who's an African American. He was once a super wealthy a businessman, but now he's just kind of working two jobs, you know, not making it, living paycheck to paycheck because his father has Parkinson's. And so he's spending all this money on medicine and on taking care of him that he just has no time and no money anymore. And so I talked a great deal with him, but I wasn't able to talk with him too long because, you know, he was a busy guy. And he's just like, hey, this is really all I can give. I really wish I can give so much more. But, you know, I really believe in the cause that you're fighting for. You know, because it was a gay rights organization. I really think, as a black man, inequality is something that I really hate, and it's something that we should all be fighting for. So this is a cause I strongly believe in as well. I want to give you so much more than what I can give you, but right now, my financial situation is not great. My father has Parkinson's. I'm just surviving barely on the two jobs that I have. So I thank you for coming here to me. But this is what I can give to you. He gave, I can't remember quite exactly the amount, but it was not a huge amount. It was like $35. And to me, that $35 meant so much to me, just being able to encourage this person to give that, to give that, and to fundraise that $35 for this gay civil rights organization. It felt like such a powerful moment to me. Not because $35 is a big amount, but because that's the most he could give, even though he was in such a hard situation. And just the best part about, to me, my favorite thing about being a canvasser was seeing that, you know, seeing generosity of people in action and having been the one to kind of encourage that generosity out of people. So yeah, that's my story, and I'll end my video with that.